data sheets will create plan views for your room, for each of the rooms that you select. It will also create elevations and place the created views on a sheet, creating the room data sheets. So let me just quickly demonstrate how it works. You can select multiple rooms or you can select one and then select the title block of your sheet. I'm gonna pick A1 sheet number. It would automatically increment the values of the sheets if you select multiple views. So you can start from a number and it would just keep adding. The crop offset is the offset around your room. If you want to include more or less around it, context around it.
Yeah.
You can also assign view template for your views if you want to automatically make them look a certain way and also change their scale. This is the easiest way to control them. And click OK.
And now in the background, it's going to create the elevation. Yeah, there it is. It's going to orient it to the room.
It will orient it to the longest border of your room. It's going to be, the elevation is going to be parallel to the longest border of your room. A little window pops out and you can go to the sheet that was created. So let's see what happened here.
Look at that. Amazing.
Depending on the sizes of the rooms, you can get different results. And it's up to you to maybe apply a smaller scale or maybe later reposition them because not all rooms will fit on the sheet the same way. So what the script does, again, it creates this crop around the room, taking into account the rotation of the project north as well. So it will rotate and align your crop to the room. If this is the outline of the room, from that outline, it creates an offset, which you can control and modify. You can make it more or less
smaller
or larger. The same works for the elevations. You can the same offset will be applied to the elevation. So here, for instance, it is slightly higher because it offset 300 millimeters
from the
room itself. So if you want to correct that, and you can correct the height of the room, and next time you run it, it would be a little bit more precise.
Yeah. Always fix your rooms before that.
Yes. But if you're not happy, you can, of course, delete the sheet and rerun it again. You can run it on multiple rooms at the same time. It will take a little bit longer, but in the end, it's much faster than doing this manually.
How many rooms is the largest amount of rooms you've tested it against? All of those, for example? I'm curious.
Yes, you can. It does. It will take up to 5 minutes, I think. It will take about 2 minutes.
But it's going to process them.
Yes. It works best on rooms with simple shapes. If the shape of the room is slightly more complex, it would not exactly recreate the crop region, but crop it to the bounding box instead.
And so some naturally would be kind of insane, that lounge room. If you imagine that this is the shape, like, few corridors, that whole thing as a room, of course it's not gonna, but in this case it's partitioned, so it's gonna be fine.
This one
will be tricky, right?
I think this one will be, I haven't actually tested it. Should I test now? Okay, I'm gonna test this one and another one which is not rectangular.
This one is gonna run.
Yes, this one is going to run. The elevations don't work very well for this one. I still haven't figured out why.
Horizontal.
It
rotated the other way around.
Yes.
I think maybe it's correct. It just flipped.
Yes. So this is nice. The irregular shape, and it very neatly cuts out the shape of your room, which is something that a lot of users want. This was on the request. So it did cut it out here, but it didn't rotate it because the shape of the room is slightly more complex.
Yeah, no, that's fair game. I think just even the fact that I really like combinations of computation plus automation plus manual stuff, because you couldn't basically foresee all the different scenarios that you're going to be facing. And with this approach, it allows you to manually run, select part of the rooms that you want to run against. Just the sheer fact that you're creating those views and you're placing them on a sheet, you're creating a sheet as well. That saves so much clicking and hustle. Then you can, of course, manually distribute them, rename them, whatever, change scales, apply new view templates. But a lot of the work has been done for you already. So it's super valuable tool.
Exactly. These are just separately creating the plan views and separately creating the elevations. If you don't need the entire sheet, you can do this just for plans or just for elevations.
Yeah.
So it would do the same thing, just creating plans. And you can go and check them out.
And then for elevations?
And then for elevations, it will create the markers for the elevations and rotate them again along the longest border of your room.
Yeah, that's good, that's good. Okay, so this one is the room data sheet tool. Perfect.